Hello there, welcome. We're going to talk about homeostasis today, which is about balance. Homeostasis is the condition where the internal environment is maintained. That's a dynamic condition. If you think about what you know about cells are the building blocks of life, and they have plasma membranes to keep the outside out and the inside in. And inside cells usually needs to be a much more stable, specific, tailored environment than the external environment is. If we look at this space outlined by the red box, this is supposed to be an organism, and in an organism are cells represented by these Friday looking things. And the environment here needs to be kept pretty stable. We have small fluctuations. We always do. Sometimes we need them. If you think of blood pressure, sometimes we want our blood pressure to be a little higher so that we can respond to the environment or perform better on physical things. If we're about to run a sprint, we need higher blood pressure than we do at rest. But we still want to keep it within a certain area. And we're living in an environment where there are huge fluctuations, where things change outside all the time, and we can't change inside as much as the external environment does. If you think about what we have going on outside, the temperature outside here in New England, where I'm making this, we can be easily well below zero in the winter, it can be over 100 in the summer, and even on a given day, we can change 20, 30, 40 degrees. But inside, we need about 37 degrees Celsius, that's 98.6 Fahrenheit. And even a few degrees difference, I'm sure you all know very well, even less than 2 degrees difference, 100 degrees, you don't feel too good. Over 106, if you haven't got immediate help, that's the end of it. The opposite direction is just as crucial. If you're 95 degrees or under without help, you're going to die of hypothermia. So our temperature has to stay within a very small range, a very sweet spot for things to be good. Water in the external environment changes a lot. Besides rain and things, humidity can make a big difference. Where inside, we need to keep a very specific amount of water. You'll remember learning that water is amazing for one reason, because it is a substance in which reactions can occur. So the human body can't work unless its environment stays just the right moisture, not too much. That'll throw off a whole lot of ions, and you'll learn through this course how important those balances are. We also have resources coming and going outside. There are times of feast and times of famine. Inside, we have to control things very carefully and have a lot of really specialized ways of getting around those times. Homeostasis can also manage things like blood pressure, heart rate, respiratory rate, digestive rate, things like that. And these are things, think about blood pressure or digestion, we do want them to be higher or more active, sometimes lower at other times, but we have to have them in just the right place, just right. So like Goldilocks, we're looking for that situation where everything is just right, what I might call the sweet spot, no matter what changes in the outside environment and no matter what changes in the inside. If you think about Goldilocks here, about to eat a big bowl of porridge, in not too long, that's going to be a whole lot of sugar in her GI tract, and shortly after that, a whole lot of sugar in her bloodstream. If you'll remember, that's mostly starch in that bowl, and starch breaks down to sugar very quickly. Having a whole lot of sugar in the blood is not so great, so we need to do something about that. But of course, taking in a lot of energy source is very good for the body, and we know how to store it and make use of it. So we just need something to balance where it is and what it does in the body. So we do have these ways to balance, to reduce the internal changes. We do this with homeostatic mechanisms, and we have a whole ton of different ones in the body. Some are very, very simple, carried out by a single cell type. Other ones are complex and are going to involve systems, perhaps endocrine or nervous systems, which are the control systems in our body. A homeostatic mechanism, also called homeostatic control mechanisms, are physiologic control systems that use negative feedback or positive feedback to maintain a dynamic balance, meaning it doesn't stay exactly the same. Things shift a little, but these mechanisms don't allow the shifts to go too far. A homeostatic mechanism is going to have three parts, three components. And these include a receptor, a control center, and an effector. And these work together to maintain the balance. So if we have an imbalance in something, which we call the variable, we have these parts of the system that will sense it, know what to do about it, and affect that change. So a receptor is there to sense the change that's happening, the change in the internal environment. I'm going to use some examples for you. One might be an increase or a decrease in blood sugar levels. Another thing that could be sensed is a rise or drop in body temperature. Or we could sense an increase or a decrease in blood pressure. The receptor is just going to be something that knows that's going on and can pass the message on to the control center. The control center is the part of the system that knows where we should be at, where our sweet spot is, what is just right. And so it gets information from the receptor telling it what the state is, and if it's not where we should be, it decides what action to take so that we can get back to that state. And it's working all the time just to maintain that state. So in the examples we're using, if the blood sugar should change too much, alpha or beta cells of the pancreas will act as a control center. If the body veers too much from 37 degrees Celsius, the brain will be involved as a control center to bring that back in line. And if blood pressure should change, say it went too low, we might have an endocrine organ acting as a control center. The control center is going to send a command to the effector. The effector is the part that can carry out this order and actually make something change, make things return to the desired balance. The effector will get the order from the control center, and it actually has the power to take action to make that change. So for instance, beta cells of the pancreas can release insulin, which will tell other cells to take glucose up out of the bloodstream. So we've lowered blood glucose levels. Sweat glands will respond to the brain's command and release sweat to the surface of the body, so evaporation will cool us. And if blood pressure was too low, an endocrine organ could release antidiuretic hormone, which would go to kidney cells. Kidney cells would concentrate urine, recovering water. That water winds up in the bloodstream, making more volume, which raises blood pressure, keeping us from passing out, which is always a good thing, I think. So again, we have our receptor, our control center, and our effector, and these are going to work together to keep us in balance. The receptor can sense a change, let the control center know. Control center orders the effector, which creates a response. Now, homeostatic mechanisms are all very specific, kind of like you learned with enzymes. Each one regulates one thing, and what's being regulated is the variable. And the examples we looked at so far, our variables were temperature, body temperature, blood sugar concentration, or blood pressure. So homeostatic mechanisms, the receptor, control center, effector, are turned on by a stimulus, something that stimulates the receptor. Very often the variable and the stimulus are the same thing, but take care because occasionally that's not the case. There's some other thing that stimulates the receptor that does let the receptor know that there's a change in the variable, but it's not directly the variable. So the stimulus is going to trigger or stimulate the receptor. We have the same thing going on here, where the variable here level is in balance in homeostasis, but if it should change, the receptor will respond to this change, sending information to the control center, which sends a command to the effector, which carries out some action that returns the variable to that sweet spot. There are two different kinds of homeostatic mechanisms found in the human body: negative feedback systems and positive feedback systems. And we'll be talking about these feedback systems in Homeostasis Part 2. Check back and watch that one. Thank you.